And we're going to begin with something we expect to talk about in January, February, maybe even March, but April, the storms that are bringing snow to millions.
Man, this snowstorm, it seemed like this was going to be the monkey wrench in this opportunity. Being stranded in an airport, and it's like, is this snowstorm going to keep me from getting my first Mears turkey?
The airport advises passengers to check with their airline about any delays or cancellations.
To tomorrow morning, where we are likely to break record low temperatures, so it is going to be very, very cold.
Crazy thing, there was an epic snowstorm coming through this part of the country, and we made it barely in time. Pete and David are stuck in an airport somewhere. We don't know if they're actually going to show up or not to hunt with us, but either way, we got out and had an opportunity to hunt turkeys in the snow, something we've never done before. I have always dreamed of one day killing a Merriam's turkey. And here I am in the snow on this mountaintop chasing Merriam's turkeys. They're gobbling like crazy. And when this bird comes and works in, it is surreal. I can't believe this is happening. I can't believe I've been blessed with this opportunity. It's like a sacred moment right here in the mountains in the snow.
Nice.
The sun is up, the temperatures are rising. Pete and David were finally able to make it in from the airport, and David's up to bat.
All my life I've lived outdoors. I was fortunate enough to have a dad that invested time in me, and I'm more comfortable being outside. I mean, that is who I am, born and raised. And I would never change that for anybody, period.
Black Hills are an incredible place for wildlife. If you want to come to a place that just has boatloads of Merriams, this is a place to go.
My dad has talked about having his basic training in Cheyenne, Wyoming. My dad died less than a month ago, but to get out here and to connect with him, I think that's what it's all about. The night before he went into the hospital, he said, and you remember, I did it my way.
So David is on a mission to call in his Merriam's turkey without using decoys. And we had no decoys, and they came close. We had incredible encounters, but we just could not seal the deal.
You know, why don't I use decoys? It's I use my experiences to get me in a position so that I can, you know, kill the turkey before he gets a chance to see me and get away. what do I need to do to make this happen? A light popped in my head and I was like, you know, I can get those guys to call behind me and I can ease up a little closer to that turkey. And so that was just kind of natural for me to say, hey, will you go ahead and call?
We're calling and it almost sounds like hens are moving away. It was really a team effort.
That's what hunting is about. That's what will help save hunting for the future, because you get just as much joy, if not more, out of watching somebody else harvest a turkey than you do on your own.
We had to work to get that turkey.
Makes it so much sweeter, doesn't it? When you work like crazy and then finally have success.
And actually a team effort.
Yeah.
Turkey hunting will never grow old for me. It's a beautiful thing. Beautiful turkeys, look at that. Everybody has been giving me a hard time about turkey hunting for my first Miriams my way. And actually that's a parallel with the way that my dad lived his life. And so on this hunt, people are saying, well, you know, you might want to use that decoy. It was a sense of pride and accomplishment to do it my way. You know, everybody that decided to get into turkey hunting, they will develop their own way of chasing turkeys, and that's okay.
As awesome as turkey hunting is, it's always about something bigger, and that bigger thing is the people that we're creating memories with that will last a lifetime. We got to watch David kill his first Miriam's turkey, and I also got to take my first Miriam's turkey ever. What an unbelievable experience this has been.